Florida Fish and Wildlife has said in the past that we should kill these iguanas that are popping up in backyards. But now they're backpedaling a little bit. One guy even got shot with a BB gun when someone was trying to kill them. So it's kind of a little dangerous out there. NBC2's Megan Myers is live right now in Collier County on Merkel Island. And Megan, what's going down there with all these iguanas?
Well, at first, FWC was recommending to people to kill those iguanas on their property whenever possible. But if you take a look at this press release that they just sent out yesterday, now they're taking a slightly softer approach, saying that this is not the Wild West and they don't want people to be shooting up iguanas. And they are asking people to seek help from a professional if you cannot remove that iguana from your property safely. Now, here in Merkel Island, a lot of people have faced troubles with these green iguanas. They say that they rip up their seawall. And FWC tells us that's not all that these iguanas can do. They also can tear up our sidewalks, and they also pose a threat to different plants and animals that are native here to the Sunshine State. And we spoke to some people who tell us that although they faced annoyances with these green iguanas, they still feel like that original request from FWC was a little bit extreme.
Finally, it took them days and days in order to finally say, let's do this humanely. And it took them weeks to say, this is not the Wild West.
After receiving those mixed emotions from people, FWC is really trying to make it clear that they want you to seek help from a professional, and they are recommending that you get in contact with an iguana trapper. I'm live in Merkel Island. Megan Myers, NBC2.
And earlier this summer, we told you about the Nile monitor and its cousin, the Asian water monitor, which have been appearing in a few different times. FWC says they can eat alligator, bird, and turtle eggs and cause some big problems in the environment. They usually get released into the wild by people who have used them as pets. If you see one of these, call FWC's exotic species hotline and they'll take care of them on their own.